The latest version of the Do More Designer PLC programming software is up and free to download now. Now, this lists some of the new features that are included inside this new software release, and a full listing can be found in the updates PDF that comes in the installation folder. For the rest of this video, we will highlight on two major improvements. First, we will cover the added support for the new DuraPulse GS4 VFD as an Ethernet I/O slave with the use of a GS-EDRV100. And then we will cover the secure email with DNS support. To implement these new improvements, you'll need to download this new software, which you can find a link in the description below, or click on this message in the top right-hand corner. You'll also need to update your firmware on your PLC to implement these new features. So while connected to your CPU with the new version of software, first select to save your project and write that project to your PLC. This will update your CPU project to the newest version. Now go into your system information and anywhere you see asterisks, select update. When everything is up to date, your Do More version should read 2.2. To add a GS4 drive to your Do More CPU through Ethernet I/O, first the drive must be connected to a GS-EDRV100 that has the latest firmware installed, then open up your system configuration. Under CPU configuration, make sure that this option is turned on. As soon as you turn it on, you'll see the Ethernet I/O master option in the configuration tree on the left. Open up the Ethernet I/O master, select Setup Slave Ethernet Port. Here you can change the IP address of your EDRV100 to be on the same subnet as your CPU. So here's the IP address of my CPU, and this is what I'm going to load into my EDRV100. Select Add Multiple Slaves. Select your drive. Now I'm going to go back in right here and select for my CPU to stay in run if there is an error. Now that's something you're going to have to evaluate if it works for your situation or not. Now once you have that set up, all you'll need to do is save your project and load it to the CPU. Now one other thing I want to show you here. Go under your memory here. And under specialty, you'll see your GS-EDRV100. By bringing this drive into your project under Ethernet I/O Master, it sets up these variables that you can use in your programming to control the drive or set up the drive. Now let's take a look at the secure email with DNS support. Do More has had email previously. Now it's adding SSL and TLS encryption. This is just encryption that's used by most standard email servers today, like, for example, Gmail. Adding the DNS portion of this allows for you to use a naming convention instead of a direct IP address. Now let's run down a quick example of how to set up Gmail with Do More. So go into your system configuration,
and under device configuration, select new device.
Then select add an SMTP client. Now give your device a name. Now the rest of this information I got directly from Gmail, which you'll need to do with your individual email provider. Enter in your server name, enable encryption if that's what you need, verify that you have the correct server port. Now this comes directly from your email service provider, and enter in the email address associated with this email account. Now if your email requires login, select Authentication Login, and enter in your username and password.
Select to verify your server configuration. Now there is a very important distinction here. This is testing your server settings from the PC using the Designer software. You will need to conduct a test email from your PLC to verify that those settings work from your PLC's network connection.
Now let's drop a simple test email instruction into our ladder code. Now select the device we created before.
fill out all the fields that you'll need for your email. Now, one thing you want to look at and make sure of, if you are entering in direct text, it must be contained inside of quotation marks. If not, this instruction will think that you're trying to use a tag. So just remember, text needs quotation marks. You can also attach a file. That would be really useful if you're trying to email your log files. Make sure to give your instruction unique CBITs for success and error. These are very important to verify that you're getting good communication and to troubleshoot this instruction. Now accept the instruction. Now since this is just a test email, I'm going to trigger this instruction with a rising edge CBIT. Now trigger your instruction, and you should see a success. If you do not, go back and verify all your SMTP settings with your email account. So that's what's new for Do More Designer 2.2. We're really excited about these updates, and there are many more to come. So please monitor our YouTube channel for updates. If you have any questions, please feel free to call into tech support or also visit our new video landing page for more videos and solutions on the Do More Designer platform.